Fans coming on. Good after evening. Welcome back to another episode here in the Off-Grid Garage. Well, that's actually not true. It's not an episode. It's not a video. It's a series of videos. I'm serious. It's a series of videos now. Well, it is about stage two of my solar installations. As you know, we only have solar panels here on the roof pointing to the east at the moment. And I still have solar panels in the back of the garage waiting to be mounted here on the west side of the garage. And this is what the whole series is about. I was planning to make only one video because it's not too much interesting stuff to mount solar panels on a roof, you know. So the plan was to make only one video, 10-15 minutes long maybe or something, and give you a summary about the installation and what the thought process was and all this kind of stuff. Well, as you know, I'm not as good in making short videos. I probably could talk 24/7. And it took me several days to install these solar panels on top of the garage. It is still not finished. I'm in the middle of the process, but I'm starting this series now because I have already filmed some of the stuff. Well, it's getting complicated now. Well, I'm sharing my thought process about this whole installation as well as I'm talking about other stuff here related to the off-grid garage and solar in general. And I had a look at all this footage and I said, well, this is not a 10 to 15 minute video anymore. This is probably more like a 6 hour show now. And because I was not only talking about the installation I'm currently doing, but also about other stuff related to this whole system here, I thought, well, let's just do like a daily vlog, like an episode, like a daily video about what I'm doing here in the garage and my thought processes about the whole stuff. And I've got a lot of thought processes, actually. Well, anyway, day number one is following right after this video here, right after I make this intro now, which is already far too long. You may not learn that much from all this, what I'm saying, what I'm showing you. You know, just take it as a pure entertainment, as a show, as a daily vlog now for the next couple of 2, 3, 4 days maybe or something. This will all be stage number two here. 1.7 kilowatt additional solar power going in, well, going on top. And this is what this mini series is about. All right, I'm serious. Crack a can of beer and enjoy the show. Hey guys, back on the roof. Yeah, I just wanted to plan the next stage of solar installation here on the off-grid garage. We've got still 9 panels down in the garage. There's not much benefit from having them down there. They need to be here on the roof. So you can see already the shading here a little bit. Ah, of course, we've got clouds as well. Yeah, there you can see the silhouette of the shading, a little bit shading over there. I probably eventually will take these ones down here, these test environments panels. Well, who knows? Who knows? Okay, don't worry about that. Okay, so the panels are 158 centimeters. So let's say 160. That would be from here, from there, all the way down. Yeah, nah, that's not gonna fit. Damn it, it's a little bit too short. I cannot put the solar panels over the gutter there. I need to clean the gutter from time to time. So this needs to be accessible. Damn it. And the other way is 80. They are 80 wide. What is Betty doing there? Hey, Betty. He's scratching her head. All right, let's do the other trick. 80. This is 160 then. There are 2 panels and then there will be another 80 down there. And then we've got so much space. That's not ideal either. Let me think for a moment. Ah, by the way, welcome back to another video here from the off-grid garage. We are off-grid, we are on top of the garage and planning the next stage of solar installation. I need more power. I need more power for this battery and charging the car. So, the other solar panels, the 190 watt solar panels, have the same length, but they are not as wide as these ones. These are a meter wide and the other ones are only 80. And 80 will start from here all the way down to here. So I have only three mounts then for these panels. Is that good or not so good? Because it will be a similar setup to there. There are three panels, the same constellation as here, just not as wide. So I have more space at the bottom or at the top. Again, one of these decisions, you know. All right, so this is exactly 2.50 meters now. And so this can carry three panels. Yes, three panels are... So three panels are 2.45 and the rail is 2.50. So we've got 5 centimeters slack. That's perfect. That's perfect. Here, there was a ground clamp connected to one of the rails here, totally corroded, and it looks like the cable has been just squeezed into this gap here, and then they tightened this screw. I just want to see if it has actually contact to the copper. Is this a common thing? Is this how you do it? That looks very dodgy to me. Here it comes. Totally corroded. So this is the only part where it actually touched the cable inside. They didn't even bother to strip the insulation of the cable. That is insane. That's not how it's supposed to work. I mean, that they have doubled up the cable, that's fine here, but you need to strip it before you do that. I don't think that was legal. Dodgy ass. All right, I clean this up with WD-40 and then I reuse it for one of the rails. So, and here's the situation now. I can use two of these rails here. They are 1.7 meters. And I've got another piece here, which is 65 centimeters, which gives me then 2.5 meters all in total. So we can fit 1, 2, 3 panels here onto this rail. Perfect. So guys, here's the problem now. I cannot find any of these clamps or nuts on eBay. This is the Glenergy system, and they have the old ones I used before. So with the offset wings, and these ones are different. You can get them from, you can get similar ones, but they don't have an offset. See, this clamp is higher than this one. Well, this one is lower, and it fits perfectly into this rail system here. Look at this. Perfect. That's a perfect fit, right? I could potentially use these ones here, the old ones, but they are not really straight. See, they are a bit of an angle. They would be straight like this. So I cannot find any of these ones here. I've contacted the seller I bought before and said, look, this is the same company, the same brand. Have you got these ones in stock somehow? And so I need to wait for them to get back to me and see if we can source some of these nuts and clamps, middle clamps, end clamps, and roof mounting brackets, these L foot brackets. All right, I'll postpone this video until I hear back. Well, this didn't get me far, right? Not the right parts. The measurements on the roof are not optimal, so I'm losing a lot of space actually with these solar panels because the roof is not optimal for this size of panels. But that's just what it is, you know? What can you do? I got in contact with SolarMart, my preferred solar shop here in Australia. And Raj got back to me within half an hour and said, well, this is actually not a Clenergy system what you have there. This is a Crasol system and a very old one, probably 10 years old. And parts are non-existent anymore. So I could not get the right gear for these rails anymore. And I said to him, well, what can we do? We order the new ones from the Clenergy system and make them work, right? So as you have seen, they fit into the rail system. They are not really straight. They are a little bit on an angle, though, but I tested it with some middle and end clamps and everything, and they are working perfectly fine. There's nothing loose or something. And both claws of these nuts, they actually clip into the rail system and hold everything very strong. It's only half a millimeter, maybe. Well, the alternative would be to buy a new rail system altogether. And I don't want to waste these profiles. They are perfectly fine. So I'm reusing these rail profiles with the new brackets and nuts, and it'll work, hopefully. By the way, guys, it is 0 amps outside. All right, you have a good night. We see us tomorrow morning again with the next episode. Stage 2, installing more solar here on the Off-Grid Garage. Until then, stay charged, stay safe, and I'll catch you tomorrow morning again. See you then. Bye-bye.